The König Wolf Round 2, Winter Camo Edition featuring the Heavy Arms Extras. This is basically a how-to or walkthrough of a simple and effective way to customize the kit without needing too much to get it done. So hopefully I've been able to properly express and guide you through how I did this and make it so you can understand it and get it done. And if you only have the basic König kit, don't worry, you can get this done without the Heavy Arms Extras. Given the factory color scheme, it's super simple to build upon thanks to the white armor and dark underbody, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing here, and all I've used was an A4 sheet of masking paper, three paints being medium, bluish, and very dark grey, and that's it. Tool-wise, you're going to need a sharp hobby knife, access to an A4 capable printer, and preferred but not required is an airbrush setup. Now you can do this how I've done here without using an airbrush, using TS sprays by Tamiya or nice fine modeling sprays, and you'll need the previously mentioned colors as well as the masking paper. But just note, depending on how thick you apply the coats you spray on, when you remove the masking it may have little ridges where you've masked off. A steady hand and careful treatment can fix these little ridges, so if you don't rush it, it won't be too bad to fix up. And with that, let's get into it. Step 1. With mine, I set out and built the wolf itself, ignoring anything white, right on through to the cannons and missiles, and if you can tackle yours like that, I do recommend it. Basically, if you can't build it because it requires something that's white, build what you can and move around forward. When you've built all of the sections, stash them back in the box for now and get your white bits out. Clean all of them up, and for the continuity of the camouflage, build or place what you can together. And for the shoulder sections, you won't need the two top front pieces on each side if you're using the Heavy Arms missile shoulders, but you can paint them if you're going to swap them out later. Don't glue any of the pieces you're building for the armor here, because it makes your final assembly later easier, and just be delicate with them. Now, if you don't want to do the pre-build, that's fine. Disregard all but the handling of the white armor pieces and proceed to step 2. Step 2. The camo pattern you want to base yours off, basically go for a hunt online and find a nice, preferably large pixel size of the pattern, and print it out on the A4 masking paper you've got, making sure that it fits on the piece of paper in question. Now don't stress if it doesn't come out super crisp, that's not crucial, and ensure that you're printing black and white, because color doesn't matter here and you don't need to waste it. Step 3. The lightest shade of the shapes on the paper are the sections you'll want to be cutting out and first applying on the pieces. The key here is getting nice curves and randomized shapes to apply all over the pieces. However, don't cover too much and try to keep the areas you mask off unique to opposing sides. Basically, don't replicate them all over the same, say for the left shoulder pauldron and the right. You want them to look different. Also, if you want to be strict to the placement of your camo and have continuity to what it looks like on your sheet, you can write beside the area you've cut out and label where that cut piece went, such as head or right hind leg. Step 4. Spray the medium or the lightest shade of grey you've chosen over all of the now masked off sections, and just a friendly reminder, try to aim for a nice even spray without getting too close with the can or applying it too thick. If you're not familiar with spraying, I'd advise getting a cheap can of spray to have a bit of a practice on some cardboard with first. If you're airbrushing, keep it neat and don't worry about the underside of the pieces too much. Later on, you can blanket with the darker grey as you go. As for the placement after painting, you don't need crocodile clips like I use, they just make life a little easier. You can comfortably spray them on a clean board in an area free of dust that has good ventilation. This just means that you'll need to turn them over every now and then to get the missed spots. Step 5. After all of the pieces have been given long enough to dry, you can begin cutting out the second darkest shapes on your masking sheet to place beside your previously placed masks on the pieces, or you can do what I've done, and you can cut out the random shapes that you decide and place them fairly chaotically around the parts as you see fit. This is basically up to you on how you'd like to do it. Step 6. Selecting your darkest grey, repeat what you did in step 3, but in addition, this time you can now go for the paint getting on the underside of the pieces. And this gives you a darker underside like mine, but remember to keep your sprays even and as light as you can to minimize the ridges. Again, they aren't too tricky to deal with, but if you don't want to deal with them too much, keep in mind how much paint you're applying. Step 7. With all of the armor pieces done, you're left with all of the lugs, and this is where your blue-gray comes in. For mine, I used an Imperial Japanese Navy Grey for a more muted tone to suit the other two colours and pre-existing layout of the model. But this is again up to you. Heck, you can even go with a straight up blue of some shade if you really want to here. For these, trim neatly from the sprues and just spray in batches. Don't apply too heavy, but a nice full coat will be about right here. Step 8. If you didn't pre-build any of the pieces like I have, this is the beginning of your build. But if you did pre-build and prep like I have, now you can go back and blitz through the remainder of the build, being cautious to not damage your new paintwork or break things as you pull them apart, to add onto your waiting wolf. Start by removing all of the masking from your pieces and cleaning up if it's necessary to do so. This is up to you. If you're happy with how it looks, proceed into the build, and if you want further protection before beginning, you can clear coat all of the pieces with a hobby clear. But make sure not to go too thick here either, especially if you intend to do panel lining and more. Perhaps practice clear coating something first so you can see how it sprays, but otherwise just use light controlled sprays at the recommended distance with cans is the go. Airbrushes will, I assume, be somewhat familiar with the application here. Personally, I didn't clear mine. That's because I don't really touch my things when I build them, so I don't really need the extra protection. A quick tip, don't forget to add any of the little clear pieces you've left out of, say, the leg bits or the canopy for where the pilot is, before you build too far. For a raw display of what it looks like without doing anything else, I've left mine, and as you can see, this is what it looks like when you've done the steps as followed. I'll backtrack to panel line him later on, but by default it looks much more enhanced than the basic colours, so if you do want to skip out on the panel lining, you don't have to really do it. One final note, you can do this idea with basically any camo colouring, and all it requires is you base coat the white pieces to suit the theme or environment that you're thinking of. So for desert, a light sandy yellow into a medium brown, and finally a dark brown with, say, an orangey colour for the lugs, more of a natural shade, as an example, will give you something, you know, akin to a desert environment. But the only thing you need to change really is, if you're going for one of these other colours, you add one additional colour to your palette here, so you're replacing the light effectively. You can brainstorm up a whole bunch of possibilities here, and the best part is this kit will mesh nicely with basically anything you throw at it. And that's thanks to the underbody scheme, because it just suits, I guess. Anyhow, I wish you the best of luck with your wolf, and if you try it out, I hope this gave you a little bit of inspiration or even helped you to get along the way, to some degree. If you need help, don't be shy, I don't bite. Reach out with what's up and I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can, and feel free to share if you have a crack at it. I'd love to take a look. There should be an email contact thing on my page there somewhere. Anyway, until the next one, take it easy.